Today, we are going to do an activity, conductivity test in different liquids. In this activity, we need a beaker, two electrodes. So basically, electrode is an aluminium plate with the holes we have in this activity. One buzzer. So this is a buzzer. Buzzer is a two-terminal device. The red one is positive terminal and the black one is a negative terminal. We also need one battery cap. So again, battery cap is a two terminal device. The red one is positive and the black one is negative. We also need one 9-volt battery. This is a 9-volt battery with a two terminal, positive and negative. This type of a base we need, a cup of water and salt, one double side tape. So all this material we require in this activity that is called conductivity test in different liquid. Let me tell you more about electrical conductivity. What exactly is the electrical conductivity before we can proceed with this activity? Electrical conductivity is a measure of the ability of a substance to allow the flow of an electron or electric current. Whenever we are talking about electric current that is the flow of electron require a path for the moment. For example, if you are going to school from your home, the road is the path. With the help of road, you can easily go from your home to your school. In the same way, for the flow of electron, we need a path. Path might be a wire or any conductor thing. Let me tell you more about conductor and insulator. Conductor is a thing from which the flow of electron take place. For example, a piece of metal, copper, iron nail, water. An insulator is the thing from which there is no flow of current happens. For example, a piece of rubber, wood. So in this case, or in this activity, we will learn about the conductivity as well as we can also learn about the completion of path. So let's start this activity. So firstly, we need this part and we have to put these two electrodes inside the cuts. So already we have a cut in the yellow base. So we have to put the electrodes like this. So in this way, I have put it both the electrodes. Now the next step is that I have to put this base in this beaker. In this way, I have put it both the electrodes in the yellow base and I have fitted the yellow base in the beaker. Now the next step is that I have to use the buzzer. This is a buzzer and buzzer is a two terminal device. As I told you, the red one is positive and the black one is negative. So I have to start making the connections. Both the ends must be peeled like this. So let me put. Here you can see, I have to put the wire like this inside the hole and I have to make a knot. So in this way, you have to make a knot like this. Now the next step is that we have to use the double side tape. And we have to paste it at the back side of buzzer like this. And we have to paste our buzzer like this. So in this way, I have put it the buzzer. Now the next step is that I have to use the battery cap. This is my battery cap, and battery cap is again a two terminal device. The red one is positive and the black one is negative. So let me connect the negative terminal of battery cap with the negative terminal of the buzzer like this. So in this way you have to connect negative terminal of buzzer and a battery cap together. Make sure the peeled portion will be connected with this clip. Now the next step is that I have to connect the positive terminal of this battery cap with the second electrode like this. In this way my connection is completed. So let me tell you once more how I have made the connection. I have firstly used these two electrodes and I have put it both the electrodes inside this yellow base, and after that I have connected the positive terminal of buzzer with one electrode like this. And the negative terminal of the battery cap I have connected with the negative terminal of the buzzer, and the positive terminal I have connected here like this. So in this way my connection is completed. Now the next step is that I have to attach the battery with the battery cap. Then let's see what will happen. Okay, so I have connected the battery with the battery cap, but I haven't heard any sound from the buzzer because the path is still incomplete. Here when I talked about the path between these two electrodes is still missing. So we have to fill the path, only then the flow of electrons will take place, and as a result we will hear the sound from the buzzer. And how we can complete the path? With the help of a water, because here the activity name is a conductivity test in different liquids, so we have to use the liquid. So in this case I am going to use the normal tap water. Here I am putting the normal tap water, and then let's see what will happen. When I have put in the water, immediately the sound will start coming. Let me explain you why this thing happened. When I have put in some water inside this beaker, immediately you have heard the sound. Because when I have put in the water, immediately the path will be completed between these two electrodes. And as a result, the flow of current start happening inside this water. And as a result, we have heard the sound from this buzzer. So that's why path is very, very much important for the flow of electrons or for the flow of current. Now, what will happen when I'll add a salt in this water? So when I will add the salt, so I have a normal salt, when I'll add the salt inside the water, immediately the voice will be increased or the sound will be increased. The sound from the buzzer will be increased. So let's see what will happen when I'll add some salt inside the water. The sound will increase because the salt water is a very good conductor of electricity, and when I'll add the salt, immediately the flow of electrons will move together very fastly. As a result, the sound from the buzzer will come at a very high range. So let's see what will happen when I'll add the salt inside the beaker. So I have to connect the battery again, and let's see what will happen. Now let me add some salt, and you can hear the voice will be increased, or the sound from the buzzer will be increased. So here you can see, or here you can hear, the sound from the buzzer is increasing. It is increasing because I have added the salt, and it is increasing. So as you have heard or you have seen in this video or in this activity, when I have added the salt, immediately the sound from the buzzer is increasing because salt is a very, very, very good conductor of electricity. So in this activity, we have learned that we need a path for the flow of current. Without path, the flow of current is not possible. And in this case, water will act as a path. In addition to that, you can also learn that current can also pass from a water, and salt water is a very, very good conductor of electricity. You have also learned about the conductor and insulator concept. Conductor is the thing from which the flow of electron take place, and insulator the material from which the flow of electrons are not take place. In addition to that, you can also learn that pure water or a distilled water is a poor conductor of electricity. Yes, pure water or the distilled water is a poor conductor of electricity. But the presence of even a small amount of impurities make water a good conductor. Hence, water from the taps, wells, ponds, rivers, seas, lakes, etc. conduct electricity as they contain impurities. That is why we get an electrical shock when we touch the conducting part of the electrical appliances with wet hand. Our dry hands also have sweat on them which conduct electricity. So we should never touch the conducting part of electrical devices. In this way, we have learned about the conductivity test in different liquids. Now your homework is that you can use any other water, just like in this case, we have used the tap water. Now it's your homework to use the distilled water or the boiled water or the packed water. Then you can see or you can check the conductivity of those liquids by performing the same experiment. Thank you.